We'll get started. We've got a couple of, we're going to switch around a little bit. We will get started with putting the spaghetti squash in. And I don't know if you've, anybody's familiar with that or everybody's familiar with that, with cooking it or whatever. This is a really easy thing to cook because you just pop it in the microwave. But you do have to let the steam out. So you just kind of puncture it a little bit. Just to, you don't want it exploding in your microwave. And this is, I would say this is one of the smaller spaghetti squashes. And this, of course, would go by your microwave. We're going to start this out at about 10 minutes. And we'll see. I always do it on high. We'll see what it looks like after 10 minutes. Okay. This looks really good. I don't know if you can see it. It's real soft, real soft. So that's where it's starting to crack here a little bit. So that's good. We don't want to cut it right now. Let it rest and cool for a few minutes while we move on. So that, and that's easy to do with the spaghetti squash. And I'll show you how to cut it and pull it out when it cools off just a little bit. All right, our spaghetti squash should be ready. We'll clean our board. All right. Now you still have to be just a little bit careful because this is still warm. Ouch. But we have let the steam out, so you don't have to, you know, it's hot. It's as hot as it is outside as it is inside. You know, you won't be cutting it and have it. I'm just gonna cut the top off. I usually just cut both ends off. And cut it in half, and it is juicy. All right, looks like that in the center with the seeds just kind of like a pumpkin. Of course, you want to take the seeds out. So you're just going to carefully scrape the seeds and kind of that little, you don't want to go too far, otherwise you'll take the spaghetti part out. Uh-huh. You could do that. With the spaghetti squash, it's just as easy to put it in all at once. Okay. Now, since we've got all that out, just simply take your fork and scrape the rest of this, and it comes out looking like spaghetti. As you can see, let me put some of this on a board. And this is a neat little, I like this squash because you could just put this on a plate with some butter. You can see how it's just real stringy, and that's all you do. Okay. Now we'll make the sauce for this. I like this just mixed up. You can put spaghetti sauce on it. It's a good alternative to if you didn't want to use pasta on anything and just wanted to go with something healthy. You like that, the feeling of pasta, you like that texture, whatever. This is an excellent substitute. Okay, on our Alfredo, we're going to use some, let's turn this on, some sour cream. And what else we have here? Half a cup of mozzarella. Get open. I'll just sort of eyeball that. That looks good. Okay, some Parmesan cheese. I did use the minced garlic for this. Minced garlic. a little salt and pepper. I'm going to get that all kind of stirred up. And you're just kind of, by heating this up, you're just kind of blending the flavors. Which reminds me, I'm going to stick the one I made earlier in the oven. I've got room somewhere. It says to heat this, what, to boiling? Does it say that? No, just till smooth. Just till smooth, okay. Because I didn't think that I would like the melted cheese trying to not get this too hot before I put this in, because this is hot. Put that in. And all this is good, so you want to scrape this all out of here. And you could do it over a bowl so you don't have to pull this out of the sauce. But you know, I like to live dangerously. Yow, it's hot. And that's all good. That's what you have left, because this is all good eating. In case you have any like hard or parts that aren't as separated, you want to kind of separate this as you're heating it. Basically what we've got here. You want to serve this, you know, right away while it's hot. And the cheese is melted. So when you have too many spaghetti squash in your garden or zucchinis, and you could use zucchinis for this also if you wanted to change the squashes. I think that's bubbling, so I'm going to turn that off and put it in the dish. I'll have that ready. And if you wanted to make it really a little bit more authentic Alfredo, you could heat the sauce separate, put your spaghetti squash on the plate, and pour the sauce over it.